Hello friends, welcome to YouTube channel Electronics. Today we will learn about how to find capacitance value of a capacitor by the codes printed on their surface. Capacitance is measured in farads. Since farad is too long for practical purposes, microfarads, nanofarads and picofarads are generally employed. 1 microfarad equal to 1000 nanofarads, which equals to 1 million picofarads. Electrolytic capacitors are polarized capacitors. They must be connected in the circuit according to the marking on its case. The stripe marking on its case indicates negative connection. Its capacitance value in microfarads and voltage rating is directly printed on its case. Ceramic capacitors are generally smaller in size, so 2 or 3 digits code printed on them. Their capacitance value is in picofarads. Suppose a ceramic capacitor has 47 printed on it, then its capacitance value is 47 picofarads. Likewise, if 10 printed on ceramic capacitor, then its value is 10 picofarads. In case small values with decimal point needs to be represented, then alphabet letter R is used, such as 4.1 picofarad capacitance labeled as 4R1 on ceramic capacitor surface. Sometimes alphabet letter N is used to indicate a nanofarad capacitor. For example, a capacitor labeled as 4N1 indicates 4.1 nanofarad capacitance. A 3-digit code consists of the 2 value digits and a multiplier, much like resistor color codes. Here the digits 471 indicates 470 picofarads. Likewise, the digits 104 indicates 10 multiplied with 10 to the power of 4, that gives 100 nanofarads of capacitance. Here this table shows most commonly used ceramic capacitor codes and their units conversion in picofarads, nanofarads and microfarads. You can use this table as a reference. Some capacitors have tolerance code printed on them. For example, if a ceramic capacitor has 681J printed on its surface, the alphabet letter J indicates its tolerance. 681 gives value of 680 picofarad capacitance, and J indicates a tolerance of plus or minus 5%. This table shows tolerance value of different alphabet letter codes. You can use this table as a reference. The brown colored ceramic capacitors usually have an underline below the marking, which means its voltage rating is 50 volts or 100 volts. If there is no underline, then the voltage rating is 500 volts. Some capacitors have 2 kV and 1 kV printed on their surface. 2 kV indicates voltage rating of 2000 volts and 1 kV indicates voltage rating of 1000 volts. If a capacitor marked with 2A474J, the first 2 digits 2A indicates voltage rating of that capacitor and can be decoded from the table shown here. 2A is a 100 volt DC rating according to EIA Standard Voltage Rating Table. If 2C printed on capacitor surface, then its voltage rating is 160 volts DC. Tantalum and aluminum electrolytic SMD capacitors are polarized. Great care must be taken to ensure the polarity marking on their case before inserting them in a circuit, while ceramic SMD capacitors are non-polarized, so we can connect them in any direction on a circuit. Aluminium electrolytic capacitors negative lead indicated by a stripe marking on their case, while the stripe marking on tantalum capacitor surface indicates positive connection. In some SMD tantalum capacitors, the capacitance value and working voltage is directly printed on their surface. Like here, 33 microfarads, 16 volts capacitance value of this capacitor. Note that the bar marking indicates positive connection. In many cases, the three figure format is normally used, where the first two digits indicate significant figures, and the third digit indicates a multiplier. The alphabet letter indicates voltage rating. The table shows the voltage rating value for different alphabet letters. So the capacitor shown here has a capacitance value of 4.7 microfarads with voltage rating of 25 volts. Some SMD capacitors have additional information like manufacturer's logo, year of manufacturing, week number, batch ID printed on their surface. SMD Aluminum Electrolytic Capacitors are polarized, whose negative contact is marked on the case. The series type is indicated with two alphabet letters. The two-digit numerical number indicates capacitance in microfarads. Here it is 22 microfarads. Voltage rating is indicated with alphabet letter. The table shows SMD electrolytic capacitor voltage codes. Here C means 16 volts. Hence the capacitance value of this capacitor is 22 microfarads, 16 volts. An additional information, lot number is also printed on the case. Another type of series is AFK series. Capacitance value is indicated with 3 digits. It is 220 microfarads capacitor. Alphabet letter capital J indicates voltage rating of 63 volts. So the capacitance value is 220 microfarads 63 volts. The three alphabet letters at the bottom indicates lot number. The other type of format is Chemet's EDK series, where capacitance in microfarads and voltage rating is directly printed on their surface. Here the capacitance value of this capacitor is 100 microfarads 50 volts. Year and month of manufacture is printed at bottom. Here this capacitor is manufactured in November 2006. The part number of a SMD aluminum capacitor represents its series type, capacitance value, voltage rating, tolerance, size and etc. We must refer the part number before placing an order. Almost 99.9% of SMD ceramic capacitors are not marked at all. The color of the ceramic body material can be sometimes helpful to identify its value. White colored ceramic capacitors are usually class 1 capacitors. Light brown colored ones are generally class 2 capacitors. Black or dark brown colored ceramic capacitors are usually class 3 capacitors. Class 1 ceramic capacitors are COG, NPO, multi-layer ceramic capacitors, usually in white color. They have very low capacitance values from below 1 picofarad to some tens of picofarads. Class 2 ceramic capacitors are X7R, X5R ceramic capacitors, usually in light brown color. They are suitable for higher capacitance applications. Their capacitance values in the range between nanofarads to microfarads. Class 3 type of capacitors are Y5V, Z5U ceramic capacitors, usually in black or dark brown color. These capacitors are general purpose ceramic capacitors made for use in limited temperature range. Extreme capacitances are possible, but this type of capacitors are highly nonlinear, exhibit much lower capacitance at higher voltages and at high temperatures. SMD ceramic capacitors' capacitance has to be measured carefully, probably at multiple voltages. Finding the manufacturer and the accurate part number might be impossible, but finding suitable replacement part is easy. SMD tantalum and ceramic capacitors are often marked with a two-digit EIA code, an alphabet letter and a numerical number to indicate their value. This table shows the alphabet letter code and its significant figure value in picofarads, and numeric number code and its corresponding multiplier value. By using this table, we can find out the capacitance value of EIA marked SMD capacitor. Suppose if it is printed S7 on SMD tantalum capacitor surface, S represents 4.7 picofarads and 7 represents multiplier of 10 to the power of 7. Hence the capacitance value is 47 microfarads. Another alphabet letter at the bottom, J, indicates voltage rating of 6.3 volts. Hence it is 47 microfarad 6.3 volt capacitor. If K with a small bar at top and A5 is printed on a SMD ceramic capacitor surface, K indicates ID of the manufacturer and A5 indicates 2-digit EIA standard SMD capacitor code. Here A indicates 1 picofarad and 5 indicates multiplier of 10 to the power of 5. So it is 100 nanofarad capacitor. That's all about capacitor's coding scheme. If you have learned from this video, please do mention them in the comment section below. In next video, we will discuss about inductors. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please click the like button. Help others to learn by sharing this video. Please subscribe and turn on notifications for more such videos. Have a nice day.